You've had, or sat through, about 189 assemblies today. Doesn't sound like a lot. You've had some funny ones, some interesting ones, some ones that make you think, and some by Mr. McGlone.
That's low.
He's not even here.
Poor guy.
This is your day. This is the time for us, all of us, the whole school, to say goodbye to you. And congratulations on reaching this point and to wish you well for the future. Now, I know that when you arrived in year seven, wet behind the ears, little ones, you probably couldn't imagine yourselves sitting right at the back, having the privilege of sitting on the chair during Leavers' Assembly, and as you edged further and further back every year, soon the realisation dawned on you that your time was soon approaching. And every single year, either me or Miss Shelley or Dr. Lettman says to you at the beginning of year 11, this year will go in the blink of an eye. Prepare yourselves, you should be revising now. And the same thing happens every time we get to April, May, and certain people say, oh, you're right, I wish I'd paid attention, I wish I'd listened. It has gone so fast. And this is my 12th year of teaching, and I've heard it so many times over the years. Now, I'm not going to say too much more, soon be handing over to Dr. Lettman, but just to say that, to reiterate, this is your day. And although we have the whole school here today to celebrate with you, it really is about you and the 5 years that you've had with us. Okay, Dr.
Lettman, thank you.
Good morning, for the last time. The significance of the monkeys on my slide will become evident in about 5 minutes' time, okay? But you're almost there, but not quite there. So the message for you is stay calm, enjoy the day, and think about the memories that you've accumulated here over the last 5 years, most of you. I've been here for 4 years, and I remember coming out of my first English lesson 4 years ago, and let's think who I had in that class. So it was Miles, there was Joel, there was Johnny, there was James. It goes on. So someone somewhere in the timetable gave me the elite. Coming out of that room. bringing Mr. Hart and saying, I don't know what's going on here, but there's no sign of intelligent mind anywhere. And there's a Spurs going to look at his wonderful wall. And there you were, and again, and look how much progress you've made over those 4 years. So, more seriously, what you don't realise, what none of us realise, is that every day as we go about our normal everyday business, we generate memories. Every day. Today, we'll generate memories for all of you guys, and for you younger guys, I guess, who will see the activities going on. And it's not until some time later that we really understand the significance of those memories. I can think back to 1978, the day I left school in sixth form, and I remember some of those events of that day. So treasure those memories, even though you don't realise that you're creating them. And this was a maths equation that Mr. Dingway didn't teach you. So remember that two times. Crazy friends, and will generate amazing memories. Now then, I often rely on the children's books I read as a child for words of wisdom, quotations to sustain me. This is what I don't actually agree with. And never say goodbye, because saying goodbye means going away.
And going away means forgetting. It doesn't. We forget some things. Even though you will go away from this place, you will keep those memories, you'll treasure them. And even though you'll be going to different schools and sixth form places next year, you will carry on having those links. And those memories will never fade, believe me. In fact, the older you get, the stronger they come back. So it's not goodbye today, it's simply see you later. Or, as you remember from your really interesting French lessons with Mrs. Reynolds, au revoir, merci. We'll see you again. The significance of my monkeys. I'm going to show you a short film which will cause some amusement. Okay? But where when you look behind the amusing scene of a monkey showing you his bottom, okay?
Dylan.
There is a very significant message. And I guarantee that there'll be tears shed before the end of the 1.5 minutes, okay?
Tears.
Oh, is this the one that does the poo in front of
you? Should have walked up to the top of the bed, 7 minutes last.
And the affection in that scene was quite overwhelming. So in a sense today, having cared for you for 5 years, we're releasing you into the wild. And what you make of it, I know not. I hope that you will leave with the same kind of affection as you've just seen. You will only need 3 things to sustain you over the coming months and years. I rely here on my very favourite Peter Pan, just as well as all you need, guys, to survive out there is faith and trust and a little bit of pixie dust. And without further ado, all of us here, with great confidence and great affection, would like to wish you all a long goodbye.
Thank you.
and in the wise words of Freddie, complete it, mate. Now it's time to move on to bigger and better things. Although everyone is going different ways, I'm sure the strength of friendships and bonds between people won't be broken. We've had a fairly rocky time, but we've persevered and conquered high school as one. You've faced your fair share of breakups and relationships, but I believe that many lifelong friendships have been established over these short 5 years. I'm making Mr. Barrett cry with laughter, driving Mrs. Jarvis out of her job. About yourself, how well your body works in physical situations, how well you work in a team. What skills have you developed? What opportunities have you followed up? Have you participated in school competitions? Athletics, basketball, cricket, cross country, football, netball, rugby, tennis, the list goes on. Remember, as you leave, a physical education is one of the life. Look after your body, feed it well, hydrate it so it works efficiently. Find at least one activity you enjoy and move. Follow your heart and your passions in life. Be kind and generous to others. Appreciate your environment and the beauty of the world and be happy. Picture what you want to achieve. Believe it will happen. Change your thoughts and change your reality. Love being you. You are you. Enjoy life. Live it long. This is one. This year, group.
Whoa, she's a
cook. A special one for me. When I started at Holbrook during year 9, the years in previous experience was a challenging one. However, your lessons soon became ones I look forward to, with the mess, mod rocks splattering the floor, and chatter making the room buzz. Having some of you change from I'm never taking art to really enjoying it at GCSE has been such a pleasure. I hope those of you in art have had fun and enjoyed the lessons as much as I have, suggestions and all. All well, fine. It's been a pleasure to be your form tutor. I could not have asked for a better bunch, although I'm sure I've annoyed you with my daily pestering to be quiet, wear the correct uniform, and to sit in your place. I hope you enjoyed it too. I wish all of the year the very best of luck with all of your future endeavours, and remember, if you can make a mark on a piece of paper, you can draw.
This is painful, man.
Now on to Mrs. Wild. No, sorry, not Mrs.
Wild. Oh, Miss Wild again.
Hello again to all you Year 11 badgers. You may think you've escaped me, I haven't forgotten you. I particularly remember those weekly vocab tests and the detentions of people who hadn't learned the words. That means you, Miles, and Henry. I also remember the Latin tests and all those translations. Apart from Luke Shields and Paige, who usually forgot to do his homework. I remember how hard most of you worked, and I know that I really enjoyed teaching you all. There was always something happening, and it was usually something funny. You all deserve to do well, and I still miss teaching you. Good luck, everyone. Top badges. Can I ask your 11 teachers and tutors if they have any comments and so on for this assembly? They either take part in the video montage we'll see later, or they send it to you like this. Mr. Livingston went one step further and suggested we go with the Star Wars theme. And I'll play that for you in a moment. First of all, passed me a note first thing this morning. The Year 11 physics swear box, grand total, roughly £10 made for charity. Many thanks to Jack Madley for his generosity paying up for the many, many IOUs. Jack has nominated the Dogs Trust. That's not real, that's your coursework in IT. Alright, so. These were Mr. Livingston's words. The Star Wars twist.
Some people don't like Star Wars.
Is that what Han Solo does?
Stop hijacking my business.
Jimmy Fox. Turn it up.
Let
absolutely.
Nope. Oh, well, ain't that a left?
I'm just going to plug it up your old thing.
Yeah, just a big one.
Yeah, it's gone! It's me!
It's still a bit quiet.
Shh.
Ensued the battle's rage around the peninsula. Your fellow students and their teachers have been involved in a mental fight with the exam boards of Enderton here.
Oh, don't cry about me. Oh, Betty's crying. Oh, someone get her a tissue.
Whatever
fight, the more rigid hive, scum and villainy. That's just this, we're still living so intently.
Ha ha ha!
This is going to be Seth, isn't it? It's got to be Seth.
Seem to be made to suffer.
Tell you that GCSE is getting easier, and if they're bad, that education is failing and has let you down.
Exactly.
We all know just how hard you've worked over these past 5 years. We all know how much you deserve the successes that are coming your way. We all know what fine young people you really are. Some say to succeed in this world now is harder than ever, and you know what? They're right. But nothing is impossible without hard work. Nothing is out of your reach. So the lift to the top floor is out of action. The stairs will do us just fine. You can still achieve great things. The world is full of people who will judge you. Where you're from, how you talk. The important thing is you look inside and know who you are. Then you'll realise you have so much to offer, all of you. If I have one wish for you when you leave here today, it would just be that you're happy. You're all comfortable with who you are. And every one of you, although you might feel very ordinary, are anything but. You are all capable of the great things that we've all seen. We see it every day in you. We see your potential, and it's what keeps us coming back, isn't the money. One of the things I enjoy most about this job, which I feel privileged to have, is the chance to see you grow and mature into the young adults that you are today, equipped to deal with the real world. When you arrive as naive little year sevens, as I said earlier, this day seems a long way off, and yet here we are. You are now leaving us as young adults with very clear identities and personalities of your own. You are blank canvases with so much potential, so much to look forward to, and enjoy as you move to the next exciting stage of your lives. I'm hugely envious of you. You're now moving into one of the most fun periods of your lives. If I leave you with one last message before the photos and videos, it would be to think big. Now, don't just mean your plans for the future, I mean every day. And don't do it to make other people proud. Don't do it for your parents. You make them proud every day already, you might just not realise. But do it for yourselves, your parents. Never settle for second best, never settle for that'll do. Take everything you've learned here at Holbrook and think big every day. Aim for the top. Aim for the top and believe you'll make it, and you will.
I'm crying.
Here's the photo video montage.
Hello, Year 11. I hope everything will go okay for you in your exams, and obviously I hope the best wishes for the future. Hopefully you'll maintain plans of sport with some fitness, and I'll see you there and about, maybe in football. Yeah, so sweet, and one take. That is all I need, one take.
sorry to be seeing you go. So a few thank yous that I would like to say before you finally dash off to wherever it is that has decided to take you on. I can't imagine anywhere you want to. First of all, thank you very much for tolerating my various ludicrous notions over the last few years. For example, Year 11, Zoigma, not really a thing. Actually, something quite unpleasant can happen to a particular part of your body. Not actually a language technique at all. Thank you for tolerating all of my ideas about how you should have more feminist graffiti or the poo stories that we shared over D of E. Really enjoyed those, particularly yours, Charlie, which we won't talk about ever again. And what was the strange thing that happened on D of E? Something about me sleeping on a park bench with hedgehogs underneath it. We won't ever mention that ever again, but thank you very much for all of those very enjoyable moments. Equally, Romeo and Juliet, so I hope that at some point in your life you do go back to Romeo and Juliet and raise an eyebrow with me about those naked weapons. But put those aside for a moment. Some very important advice. Make sure you screw up. Make sure you screw up and admit it. Make sure you screw up in a fun and interesting way. It really is worthwhile. And secondly, find something that you really enjoy and make sure that you give up absolutely everything.
Teaching 62 of you the new maths GCSE. I knew it was hard, I knew it was tough. I knew some of you started to enjoy maths more, some of you started to hate it more. But I hope I was able to inspire a lot of you to just enjoy that beautiful subject of mathematics as much as I do. And I really want to get in that wall with a lot of grade 8 and 9 in the summer when the results come out, and I hope that happens. So many members of your year group, going back to when you were in Year 7, my beautiful form, Dina themselves, Harry, Katie, Jessica, Riz, Callum, Tyson, Hannah, and also Dan Chen. Harry, I wouldn't have forget the assembly you had when you were riding around the main hall in your unicycle. That was awesome. I think our assembly team was everybody's good at something. That memory will stick with me forever. one memory that I just wish it goes away is Sam Andrews fat jokes. Sam, yes, I know I said you should come to Dress Up Day and you're so sumo wrestling too, but Lane Harrison Baker, he made me say that. I just want to wish you the best of luck in everything you do. Good luck in the future. You guys are awesome. Sky is the limit. And I have to do that shout out to Miles Kippers now. Sorry I missed you out in the yearbook. Bye.
Pleasure knowing you, and when you see me in a pub, you owe me a drink. I will keep you to that.
Oh, sorry, I've been a little bit. Cody, I was just enjoying the game time that I've got since you've gone. Well, firstly, well done. You've survived 5 years, and of course, you've gone through your exam, so well done. Can I thank everybody who bought me this? Really nice treat from Norwich, fine city. Don't know why I've got a cheeky monkey, but I tell you what, it's much, much better than the normal stuff I get, which is an Ipswich Town top sign with the whole year group, so thanks very much for that. And of course, a special thanks to the award I got at the end of the year for the most popular teacher 2017. Now, honoured to receive this. I've actually won it quite a lot of times, but it's very special this year because I didn't really try very hard, and there's quite a few members of staff and staff for the whole of year 11 that really tried for that award, so I am honoured, and thank you very much. Obviously, it's only decent of me to thank the people who brought me close, and that was Mr. Clark and Mr. Anthony Parry. They did well, but better luck next year. Now, I can't obviously mention everybody, but I just a few shout-outs for a few people who've shocked and impressed through the 2 years. Callum Byford, for being really annoying in year 10, but much, much, much nicer
now. The Lee brothers are constantly updating me on the smell in the new drug toy and everything. Couldn't survive without that. Jessica Mills for giving me a look that communicates two rude words when I asked her to explain her history a little bit more. Dan Shern for being the most loyal member of my politics enrichment group and for predicting correctly that Jeremy Corbyn would do exceptionally in the election. Well done, Dan. Tom Watson for that laugh. Leaving their sharpenings and paper all over my desk when he went. That was funny in year 10 talk, not at the end of year 11. Erin, Molly, and Hannah, fantastic debate about the difference between a Devonshire cream tea and a Cornish cream tea. It's all about the layers of cream and jam, everybody else is not sure. Henry Barley for that ridiculous laugh. Imogen Brown, publicly I have to say sorry. I have picked on you, Imogen, in year 11, and I am sorry. So girls come back and told me this. Whenever I needed the class to be quiet, with that particular class, it was often I shouted your name. I didn't realise that, so I publicly apologise, Imogen. Henry Brown, wow, you've worked hard. Well done. And I know you can do well. Tebow, for noise. Noise and more noise. Marcus Lawrence, with fantastic energy. Grace Nicholson, for that laugh. Elise, Ellie and Emma for keeping me sane. Mrs. Burns History Group that I obviously inherited, thank you very much. Freddie and Harrison for your commitment to history, and I know you're going to do well. Brendan Backshaw for learning the difference between an inappropriate humorous comment to an appropriate humorous comment. Mr. Half nodding as well. Sadly, that took you a year and a half, but you got there. And I'm not going to wish you good luck because I don't believe in luck. I am going to wish you lots of hard work and determination and you will achieve whatever you want to achieve. Good, happy lives, please. The very best for the future. Speaking of the future, if you do see me when you're out, please don't shout out to my team. Like, hello, Mr. Barrett. It's a bit embarrassing. Shout out, please. Hello, most popular teacher of 2017. Good luck and goodbye, you and everyone.
First couple of those, please,
to recognise all
the
remember down.